Over the weekend, we got some pretty major leaks on the AMD side. Both Ryzen and Navi got some, and so did Intel. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. First, let's make something clear. These are leaks coming from a source at RedGamingTech and should be taken with a grain of salt. Let's get started with the CPU side of things. According to that source, the Ryzen 3000 series will launch on July 7th. Get it? July is the 7th month and it's going to be released on the 7th day, and of course the architecture is on 7 nanometers. This is kind of like what Nvidia did with their RTX 2080 launch by announcing it on the 20th of August, which is the 8th month, so 2080. Apparently, the actual announcement will happen about a month prior, between May 28th and June 1st, during Computex. As for the core count, we already saw the 8 core during CES, and we have confirmation from Lisa Su that we're going to see higher than 8 cores for this generation. How much higher is the real question, since AMD could go all out and release a 16-core part, or go for a 12-core CPU, which we have seen creeping up around late last month on Userbenchmark.com. They might stick to 12 until they find competition from Intel, more on that later. According to the same source, Ryzen 3000 will apparently come with higher clock speeds and much better overclocking capabilities compared to previous generation. The X570 platform, which is supposed to release at the same time, will offer better support for it, including PCIe 4.0. This change in clock speeds and overclocking is likely due to the change in how the CPUs are manufactured, going from a 12 nanometer LP process, which stands for low power, to a 7 nanometer HPC, which stands for high performance computing. Moving on to Navi, we have a bit of a similar story, although it is a little more volatile. Apparently, AMD wants to release the new GPUs at the same time as their CPUs on July 7th, with the announcement at Computex, but it looks like this date is far from rock solid. According to RedGamingTech, AMD is trying to pull every trick in the book to get the cards on the shelves by July. This contradicts previous leaks from Cal Kotlin, which states that we wouldn't see Navi until October. That leak suggested that this delay was caused by AMD's foundry allocation for the year. AMD is sort of at the mercy of TSMC for 7 nanometer products, and they're probably running at capacity at this point. Add to that the contamination issue they had a few weeks ago, and I guess we have to cross our fingers and hope for the best. I think the reason why AMD is trying to make this happen as fast as possible is because of the release of the 16 series from Nvidia. Even if Navi is a superior product, remember that a lot of people that are waiting for a new mid-range card might choose the 16 series just because it's available sooner, and those people probably won't go through the hassle to sell and buy Navi later. I'm hyped up about Navi, but I honestly don't think AMD will have it ready by July. I at least hope that they show it off at Computex, even if it gets released later in the year. And lastly, let's talk Intel. The Refresh King did show us some Sunny Cove cores during their architecture day a few months ago, but it looks like it will have to wait as leaks points toward another refresh. That's right, another 14 nanometer family is on the way. We heard about it before, and it seems like Intel is going to release Comet Lake next. What could they possibly improve on? Well, core count, of course. Comet Lake is supposed to be the first 10 core from Intel in the mainstream platform. I've said it before and I'll say it again, I honestly don't care about the process node of a CPU. What matters is its performance, and Intel always edged out the competition when it comes to single core performance. Adding cores is definitely a good strategy, as we saw with Ryzen and Threadripper, but with the third generation Ryzen CPUs coming, AMD will close that gap and possibly surpass single core performance from Intel. The blue team is in a tight spot, and unless they adjust their pricing to compete with AMD, Intel will lose the battle this year. The other thing I'm really curious about is the rest of the lineup. Will Intel re-release another 8, 6, and 4 core? Because if they do, I highly doubt that they'll be able to squeeze out more performance out of them. They might up the clock speeds, but at that point you will have less headroom to overclock, and that CPU is going to consume a lot of power. Anyways, I guess we'll have to wait and see for the 10th generation of Intel CPUs. All right, so let me know what you guys thought of today's stories down below. As usual, I will be responding to as many comments as I can. You can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, guys, and I'll see you on the next one. I gotta go play some Apex Legends.